Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and I would be denying my own cultural heritage if I did not use the following phrase. If you want blood, you've got it. Today, we talk about good guys, bad guys, crime scenes, and the Portland cop who helped to pioneer blood spatter analysis. Welcome to the Breakfast Hour. This is Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. Hi, I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome to Outlook Portland on Northwest 32 TV. As the songwriter Suzanne Vega once said, blood makes noise. And for those who know how to listen, or perhaps watch, what that blood says can be staggering. In this era of CSI, NCIS, 24/2020, and a little old serial killer named Dexter, it is hard to believe that there's a time when forensic science, specifically blood spatter analysis, wasn't taken all that seriously, and it's even harder to believe that shortly before that, it didn't exist at all. Our guest today helped to change that. Retired Chief Deputy Rod Englert spent a large portion of his career in the investigation of crime, narcotics, homicide, right here in River City. His area of expertise is blood spatter analysis. He's received his bachelor's degree in police administration from California State University at Los Angeles and has done postgraduate work in psychology. He has given more than 500 lectures and seminars about crime scene analysis in 35 states, as well as Canada, Russia, England, France, and South America. His new book is called Blood Secrets, Chronicles of a Crime Scene Reconstructionist, and it is an honor to have him here today. Hello, Mr. Rod Englert. How are you today?
Fine, thank you. Thanks for having me on your program.
Thank you for your joining me. As my mother would always ask me, she'd say, well, how did a sweet boy like you end up in television or radio or whatever it was I was doing at the time? So how did a sweet boy like you, Rod, end up in blood spatter analysis? What drew you to that as a career?
I was drawn to blood spatter after becoming a policeman and being a rookie in Los Angeles for the Downey Police Department, which is a suburb of Los Angeles. And I wasn't feeling good on this particular evening and went out on a call at midnight. It was a very foggy night, and went to an apartment complex where the apartment manager said, I think the person upstairs is dead. And so I was all crisp in my uniform, but sort of had the flu. Is very quiet and no lights on, and I went up the stairs and crept up trying to do everything that was right and opened the door, and there's this dead man laying there, and there's blood all over the walls and blood all over the floor, and he was laying there in his boxer shorts. And so I stepped in trying to be cautious not to turn on any lights, because if there's fumes or something it explodes, and I called for detectives. And I said, I think we have an axe murder, because it looks like this guy's been murdered. There's blood all over the walls, and it's some kind of instrument like an axe. And that was a horrible thing to have said, because he died from, he was vomiting. He had ulcers, and he was thrown up all over the walls, and he'd been drinking. And it took a long time to live that one down.
Because
I was embarrassed.
Every call from then on to this, hey, Rob, we got another axe murder for you to go investigate.
The detectives just rode me unmercifully, and so I learned from it. It was actually a good thing that occurred, but I did learn a great lesson from it, not to assume. And then I wanted to learn everything that I could about blood, because every time I would go, it's a weekly thing, every time I would go to a scene or just a traffic accident, there'd be blood, and those blood patterns were different. What do they mean? And I had no idea. I would sort of put them on what I call my pay it no mind list and just park it. And then I started learning and wanted to learn more, and found out there's places that you can get educated about it, which was very, very rare, and seldom could you find a class to do that.
Step back one moment and talk about your moving from Los Angeles to Portland. You were born in Texas, in Los Angeles, and then in Downing,
is
where you had been where you trained for the to be a police officer. What is it that brought you to Portland from Los Angeles? Was it the pace of the city? Was Los Angeles just too overwhelming, too gritty after a while? What was the motivation?
It was overwhelming to my three children and myself and my married life. I liked the job too much. I loved it.
Hi, I'm Rick Emerson. Now today with Mr. Rod Englert, we're hearing a lot about blood and bodies and the advancement of science. And let's not fool ourselves. The day will come, and soon, when this sort of knowledge may save your life. I am talking about the inevitable zombie vampire war, which even now is drawing closer to its horrific overture. No, don't take my word for it, though. I want you to do your own research, and there's no better place to do that research than one of our new marquee sponsors. I'm talking, of course, about Things from Another World. Now, Things from Another World is based right here in Portland, Oregon. You can find them online at tfaw.com, or even better, you should go to one of their physical locations, and I'm telling you why. Because right now, they're running what can only be described as a kick-ass sale. Now, the week of April 19th, you can save 50% on graphic novels, hundreds of them, and comic books, collectibles, fantastical items of every variety, on t-shirts, on gaming cards, and collectible figures, collectible posable figures, collectible posable bendable figures, collectible posable bendable figures that you will tell your wife are really going to be worth something someday, and they're really not toys, honey, and it's not such a big deal if I have a whole collection of Gene Simmons things sitting at home on the shelf. You know, theoretically. The week of April 26th, by the way, that sale is going to go up to 60%. 60% off as of April 26th. This week, 50% off. But you know what? Once that stuff is gone, it's gone. Now, they're replenishing things every week, and the selection at every physical location is different. So you got to go check it out for yourself. Find out store locations at tfaw.com. That is their kick-ass sale, Things from Another World. Things from Another World. Whatever you collect, they've got just the thing for your collection. When we come back, we'll talk more about that. We're talking to Mr. Rod Englert. He's the author of the book Blood Secrets, Chronicles of a Crime Scene Reconstructionist. You're watching Outlook Portland right here on Northwest 32 TV. Stay right there. This is the part where everybody wonders what we're saying as we go to commercial, because there's just music playing while we're talking. Okay. But they don't know we're not saying anything.